Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ansar Ahmad, and in today's class we are going to speak on combinational logic circuits. This is very interesting topic and I hope you will like it. It is simple and easy to understand. What is combinational circuits or what are the combinational logic circuits? As you know, there are two types of digital logic circuits in digital system. One is called combinational circuits and other is called sequential circuits. Okay, so combinational circuits, what are combinational circuits? Combinational circuits are those circuits in which output at any instant of time depends not only combination of its input. So this is the very easy definition. Combinational circuits are those circuits in which output at any instant of time depends only on the combination of its present inputs, not previous inputs or previous output. Okay, so this is the block diagram of combinational circuits. Whatever you are applying on the circuits, you are getting on the output side. And sequential circuits are those circuits in which output at any instant of time depends only on the present input as well as the previous output. What are sequential circuits? We will discuss in detail in the next unit. Okay, right now let's switch on characteristic of combinational circuits. Combinational logic circuits have no memory. This is very important difference. No memory, timing or feedback loop. Okay, see, this is a great difference between the combinational circuits and sequential circuits. Their operation is instantaneous. Instantaneous means that is whatever you apply on the inputs, it can be get on the output. A combinational logic circuit performs an operation assigned logically by a Boolean expression or truth table. So combinational circuits perform an operation which are assigned by Boolean expression or by a truth table. Okay, so this is the classification of combinational circuit. We have many types of combinational circuits which are useful in day-to-day life or day-to-day engineering. And what is their classification? Broadly, they are classified into three sections. One is arithmetic and logical functions. Those combinational circuits which help out in arithmetic and logic functions. And the very important example of arithmetic and logical functions are adders, subtractors, comparators, and PLEDs. And other category of classification of is data transmission. Data transmission logical combinational logic circuits are those circuits which help out in data transmission, such as multiplexer, demultiplexer, then encoders and then decoders. These are also very very interesting and very informative and very easy to understand. Then code converts, binary, then BCD and then 7 segments. This category transfer or convert the code. Okay, so first of all, let's have design procedure of combinational logic circuits. How we design the combinational logic circuit? Of course, it has certain steps, and by following these all steps we can design any combinational logic circuits. So in that category, first step is problem definition. That is, problem definition means what is your statement of the problem, what is your circuits which you want to design. Okay, you should know. And then identify the number of inputs and outs of the circuits. The second step is whatever your problem or the circuits you are going to design, you should identify the number of inputs and outputs of that circuits. Third step, the input and output variable assign letters symbols. So after identifying the inputs and output, then we need to assign the variables or letters to those input and output, like A, B, C, D, or X, Y, Z, or whatever. Then four, create the truth table for input and output variable. And the fourth is just creating the truth table for the input and output. So whatever you are giving the inputs and what you are going to have the outputs. Step five, get simplified Boolean function for each output. After that one, we need to have the simplified Boolean expression from truth table. And then last not least, construct logic circuit using Boolean function obtained from third step. So these are the simple 5-6 steps in which by which you can use the you can design the conventional logic circuits or make the conventional logic circuits. So we will see by an example how we are going to apply that design procedure for conventional logic circuits with an example. First is very important. The problem definition is design half adder. Okay, design half adder. This is design half adder. Design half adder. So this is the problem definition. And the second. First, let's try to know what is half adder. A half adder is a digital circuit that performs addition of two number. Okay, so this is the definition of half adder. A half adder is a digital circuit that performs addition of two numbers. So it add two numbers. The half adder adds two binary digits called as augend and addend, and produce two output as sum and carries. Okay, so half adder add two numbers which is named as augend and addend, and produce two outputs as sum and carry. Okay, so this is the block diagram of half adder, and these are the two numbers. These are the two numbers A and B. Okay, these are the input, and after adding these numbers, it gives the sum as well as carry. Okay, and this is also block diagram. One number is A and the other number is one number, and other number is other number. Other number aapka this one. Okay, and it gives the sum and carry. So this is the definition of half adder. Now we would like to design half adder, and of course we are going to use these all six steps. First is problem definition. So problem definition is simple. This is the problem definition. Okay, to design definition. Okay, to design a half adder. Okay, the second step is second step is identify the number of inputs and out of the circuits. So we can identify these are the inputs and these are the outputs. Two inputs and two outputs, sum and carry. Third is to assign the letters or symbols to these variables or inputs. So we are assigning A and B for inputs and S and C out as the output letters. Okay, and third step we have completed. Create the truth table for input and output variable. So let's have fourth step. For that step, this is the fourth step. Create the truth table. Okay, so we are going to add two numbers. Okay, two numbers. So how many combinations are possible by using two bits? That is four combinations. Okay, so four combinations are possible. 4, that is this 4 combination. So these are the inputs. Okay, these are the inputs and these are the outputs. So in place of A and B, I am going to have here, you can see X or Y. So I am considering here X, Y as the input and sum and carry out, that is carry out here. Okay. So 4 combinations we have: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. Okay. This is decimal equivalent of 4 combinations: 0, 1, 2, 3. Why I am writing this decimal, I will tell you later. Then now just we will perform the simple arithmetic X plus Y by the arithmetic rules which we have covered in very beginning. So X plus Y, 0 plus 0, sum 0 and carry also 0. Then 0 plus 1, 0 plus 1, sum 1 and carry 0. Okay. Then X, Y, X 1 plus 0, that is sum 1 and carry 0. And last is 1 plus 1, that is sum 0 and carry 1. Okay. So this is simple arithmetic operation which we have done in previous lectures, and you must recall it. It is simple. It is not a matter of discussion at all. Simply we are going to design the combinational circuits. Let's focus on it. Okay, so this was the fourth step we have completed. This is the first problem definition, and then identify the number of inputs, then input and output variables are assigned letters, X, Y and sum and carry out. We have decided create the truth table for the input and output. And the fifth step is get simplified Boolean function. Now with the help of this truth table, let's get the simplified Boolean expression. Okay, so what we will consider, we are having two outputs, so we will consider sum and carry out. So I'm going to have to simplify this truth table with the help of KMap. KMap is the easiest one, and in many places we use it to make the calculation easy and simple. Okay, so this is the two variables KMap, and after just X, Y, so 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and how you will find out, that is just note the one position, that is sum 1, 1 and equivalent decimal 1 and 2. So at 1 and 2, 0, 1, 2 and this is 3. Okay, so 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 1 and ye aapka 0 ho gaya. Now calculate it. Sum ke liye kar rahe hum, so there is no pairing at all. So what we will solve, that is X bar, that is X bar Y, this is for this one, X bar Y. Okay, ye aa gaya aapka. Then second is X Y bar. Okay, so X Y bar plus X Y bar, we can write it X XORing Y. Sum is equal to X plus X XORing Y. Now we will simplify the Boolean expression for the carry out. Carry out, that is the carry which we have. In this one you can only, there is only one carry here. So again fill the cell 0, 1, 2 and 3. This is 3. So I'm going to put here 1. Then carry is equal to, carry out is equal to XY. So we get the simplified Boolean expression for sum and carry. Now the last expression, with the help of this simplified expression, we would like to design the logic circuit which is also known as the combinational circuits. So this is simple half adder with the help of truth table. Okay, sum and carry. So sum can be, that is x plus y, because sum has the XORing. So we will make a XOR gate, and we will apply the XY on this XOR gate, and here you will get x XOR y. Okay, then for carry simply have XY. So you will take a input x from x and y, and here we are using AND gate because this is AND operation. So x, y, and we give the input AND gate, and you will have the carry output. Okay, so guys, it was the simple half adder design. I think you understand it very well, and I would like to say nothing to understand it. It's very easy. So let's have full adder, design of full adders. So what is the basic difference between the full adder and half adder? Why this is called half adder, which we have done it in the previous half adder? We noted that there is no option of carry to add. Okay, carry is just the carry, just the we note carry, but there is no option to adjust it. Okay, but in full adder we can adjust this one. Okay, so here we I would like to say, if this is a carry, and which one is this, what is the name of this one? Carry out. This was the carry out, that is, this is the carry which we received. Okay, and when we add up this carry to other digits, then this is called carry in. So the full adder adds 3 bits numbers, 2 bits as operands and 1 bit as a carry bit. Okay, so the basic difference between the full adder and half adder, half adder is a 2 bits, and full adder is a 3 bits, which adds 2 operand XY and 1 more bit, which is named the carry in or the previous carry. Full adder produces 2 output, one sum and one other, and other carry, that is out, carry out, I must say. Okay, so again, if there are three inputs, then what will be the combination of inputs? That is 2^3 is equal to 8. So there will be 3 binary inputs combination. So x, y, and c in. C in is actually the carry which will find during the addition operation, which will add up in the next bits. We'll see here 0, 0, 0. This is the one combination, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So these are 8 combination of 3 bits. Okay, now when we will add up these bits by the arithmetic operation, I'm saying again, I'm not going to discuss about that one, though this is simple. So when we designed that x plus y plus cn, then we get the 0. Okay, sum 0, carry out 0. Okay, when we add up 0, 0, xy, that is x plus y 0, 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1. So sum will be 1 and carry out will be 0. Again, when we will add up 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, then sum 1 and carry 0. Okay. Then when I will add up x plus y 1, y plus 1 is equal to 0, 1, 0. That is sum 0 and carry out 1. Okay. Then 1 plus 0 plus 0, that is 1 and sum 0. Sorry, carry 0. Then 1 plus 0 plus 1, sum 0 and carry 1. Okay, 1 plus 1 plus 0, that is sum 0 and carry 1. then 1 plus 1 plus 1. In this case, carry will also be 1. Okay, so this was the simple arithmetic operation which we performed. You can perform yourself. It is simple. We have to simply add up these x, y plus cn. Okay, now just note where we have the 1 for the sum as well as for the carry out. Actually, we are going to find out the mean terms. Okay, so this is for sum, summation m. So this is the position 1, then 2, then 4, and then 7. So these are the mean terms at which we are having sum, 1 for sum, and for carry out, just note down the position of 1. Where we have the 1 is at 3, then 5, then 6, and then 7. So these are the mean terms for sum, and these are the mean terms for carry out. Okay, now this was the fifth step, that we will apply the K-map to simplify the Boolean expression. So here K-map for sum and K-map for carry out. Okay, K-map for sum and K-map for carry out. Okay, so where we are having the mean terms, just put the 1 in place of those cell 0 0 0. Of course, what you are taking, you are taking as the LSB. Ye aap LSB le rahe hain, theek hai? Oh sorry, MSB le rahe hain, aur ye aapka MSB hai. Okay, this is just like x, y and cn. okay, ye aapka, to cn aapka ho gaya LSB. अब इसके हिसाब से देखिए 0, then 0, 0, 0, then 0, 0, 1, 1, ठीक है, then 0, 0, 1, sorry, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, ठीक है, then 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, then आपका ये आ गया 010 010, that is 2, ठीक है, then 011, then this is 3, okay, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, and this is 7. I told you K-map is very important और आपको ये आना ही चाहिए. Then in place of 1, देखिए 2, 1 पे एक ये है, 2 पे 1 है, देन आपका 4 पे 1 है, एंड देन आपका 7 पे 1 है. नाउ वी गो फॉर द पेयरिंग ऑफ वंस, एंड यू कैन ऑब्जर्व देयर इज नो पेयरिंग ऑफ 1. सो वी विल राइट द सेपरेट एक्सप्रेशन फॉर ऑल वंस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल x bar y bar c in, ठीक है, c in दिस वन. Okay, then for that one, write expression for this one, x bar y c n c in bar. Okay, then write expression for this one, x y c in, then write expression for this one, x y bar c n. Guys, when we will we will simplify it, so separate the terms so that we can find out the common. Okay, so I would like to just check in which I can take the common. So this is c in x bar y bar plus x y plus c in bar x bar y plus x y bar. Okay, just you can see this is the x bar y bar plus x y. In fact, this is x nor. Okay, so we can write it c n x XORing y, and this is the bar. If we put it, then it becomes the XNOR. Okay, so this is the XNOR. Then C in dash X bar y plus X y bar. This is simple. Okay, so then we can write it XORing y. And simply, if I want to calculate it more, then I am putting in place of let X XORing y is equal to A. So this is a C input A bar plus C in bar A. Okay. Then simply again C in A bar plus C bar A. Again it will have the XORing. That is A XORing C in. Now I will replace that is let जो मैंने let किया था let A is equal to X XORing Y. Okay, जो यहाँ पे let किया था then now finally I am going to replace the value of A. So it will be S is equal to X XORing Y XORing CN. This is for the sum. Now I will go for the KMAP carry out. And these are the minterms 3, 5, 6, 7. So as per the cell numbers, we will insert the 1 in place of minterms. In this one, you can see we are having 3 groups. One is this one, one is this one, and one is this one. And after simplify, we can have C and Y plus C in plus XY. This is the expression for carry out. Okay. Now if you understand this thing, which I hope you are getting it, then what we can do, last step is to design the full ladder. So we will like to design the full ladder. This is simple sum which we have solved by the with the help of KMAP. Carry out X plus Y C and X plus Y X XORing Y. So first of all XY will have two X Y two inputs, okay, and the other inputs is the these are the two inputs, okay, as per the problem definition. This is also input, okay. Then these are the XY two inputs. We are going to have the XORing of XY. Just see sum का देखे तो इस XOR कर देंगे then we will have the तो we will have the X XORing Y. Okay, then X XORing Y will be XORing with carry in. So this is the carry in, okay, carry in plus X plus Y. So we will get here X XORing Y XORing C in. Okay, then what's about carry out? So we got the sum carry out XY. Simply take the two terminals into the AND gate. This is AND gate XY. Okay, so take the two terminal from XY and give it to the input as AND gate, and the output of AND gate, okay, take the output of one gate because it is making the XORing. Okay, it is just going to add up with the C input. Okay, तो हमें और गेट के साथ इसे सम करना पड़ेगा. And then C in plus XY. So C in is this one, and X XORing Y is this one. Okay, because this is again an AND operation between the C in and X XORing Y. So just take out the output from two AND gates. This is XY, and this is C in. And X XORing Y. Okay, ठीक है. So you will get the carry out. So guys, it was all about the full ladder. I hope it is simple to understand. You need to follow only 6 steps. First is just problem definition. Then second, just finding the or identifying the inputs and outputs, and then third is just give the letters or symbol to the variables or inputs and outputs, and the fourth is just make the truth table of that combination of inputs and outputs, and then fifth step is simplified that truth table with the help of any methods. You have three methods, you can apply any one. I'm solving it by KMAP. You can take the algebraic sum, you can take the tabular method, whatever you like, but KMAP is easiest one. The last is, as per the simplified operation, just draw the logic diagram, and you done the combinational circuit of any device. Okay, so guys, it was all about the half adder and full adder. I hope you got it. In the next lectures, we'll talk other topics. Till then, take care and have a great time.